Kansas City. This is Madden Football on EA Sports. Mahomes and the Kansas City Chiefs taking on Josh Allen and the Buffalo Bills.
From one of the loudest venues in the NFL, there's a look at Arrowhead Stadium here in Kansas City. A few short moments ago, these two teams made their way out of the stadium tunnels, and the noise level in this place was just about off the charts. They are set for football as the Chiefs get set to do battle with the Buffalo Bills. About ready to get us going, and we are underway from Arrowhead, taking it about the one, and he's up across the 25 and down at the 28. Time to see what Patrick Mahomes can do here with his first possession. The quarterback out of Texas Tech getting set to lead this KC Chiefs offense.
And when you think of Patrick Mahomes, you start to think about all of his attributes, and you realize very quickly you can't just put him into one box. No matter how the game proceeds, no matter what is needed, he tends to have an answer for it and plays accordingly.
On first and 10, here's Mahomes. And this one caught by Travis Kelce. The game's first play produces 6 yards, brings up second down. I think defensively you're okay with that. You're in the first quarter, he's going to get some catches, but they rallied to him quickly.
And that's what you count on, and I like what you just said. First quarter, can you do it all game long? They catch it, you tackle them, they go down on the spot. Because when you're able to do that and you don't give up big chunks of yardage after the catch, now you put the offense in a position where every series, they have to work hard to pick up first downs, and you tend to stall them out when you do.
And in for the Chiefs touchdown, DeMarcus Robinson, 65 yards. And the Chiefs on just 2 plays have taken the lead. Well, if they didn't get the wake-up call before the game, they got it right now. 2 plays already in the end zone.
I think of it in boxing terms because whether it's a big shot with your first one or a probing one, a little bit of a jab, the second one was the payoff. That was the big one that landed. 1-2, end zone.
Harrison Butker is on for the extra point. And his kick is good to make it 7-0, KC. The long touchdown pass gets him 6 on a very, very tidy 2-play drive that time. Touchdown. Here's Butker on to kick it away. This taken in at the goal line. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23. Well, the Buffalo offense coming out, and it is Josh Allen who is at the helm.
And I'll bet he's talking to his guys about resisting the temptation to try and turn this into an up-and-down game, almost like basketball, where both teams press and one team gets an advantage, our team's trying to run with them, and they're just not equipped for it. Doesn't matter whether you're equipped or not, just settle in, get calm before you go for the big strikes.
Allen and the Bills now with a first and 10 at their own 23. Now the first carry for Devin Singletary. Singletary loses it, and it's picked up by the Chiefs. And his guys are going to get the football at the 37-yard line. Well, he's going to have to shake out the cobwebs. First time he touches the football, and he drops it on the ground.
So many times we talk about quarterbacks and taking care of them early to get them in the flow with safe throws, right? But with a runner, there is no such thing as a safe run, right? Right out of the gate, you're going to be in some traffic. Got to take care of the ball, and he didn't do that.
And now, as with every potential turnover, they're going to take a second look at this just to make sure. Now the question, was the knee in fact down before this ball comes loose? And is the video convincing enough to overturn it?
A lot of factors here. Remember, you also need clear possession of the football afterwards. This is a tough one to overturn.
So that challenge, a successful one. The Bills come to the line to start their next drive. And last time, not only the turnover, but that turned into 6 points. They got to make up for that here.
We always hear about empty possessions, but some are worse than others. You can have an empty possession, punt the ball away, get yourself set to play defense, but when you turn it over, it changes momentum, and when they take it downfield and punch it in on you, that's a bad possession all the way around.
Yeah, but you're hungry to get back out there, aren't you?
You better be, because otherwise, it's going to be a long day for you.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. To the air, Allen finding some room at midfield, and he'll get this down to the 39-yard line.
For many teams, the evaluation of tight ends has really changed. We used to wonder about how they would block first and foremost. Now we want to know how these guys can run, because we envision them in offenses, catch the ball, how much yardage can they gain after that?
And that on display there for a good pickup. So now first and 10 in Chiefs territory at the 39-yard line. And the catch made. This is Emmanuel Sanders. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8-yard gain, second and 2. That was a lightning-fast decision that time. He just caught it and got rid of it.
Because he saw his guy was going to be open immediately, so he took the R, the run, out of the play. He took the O, the option, out of the play, and immediately got to the pass.
On second down, here's a run with Singletary. And he's able to get it down to the 25-yard line.
Yeah, once more, strong running, excellent blocking at the point of attack. They've got a nice little drive brewing right here.
First down, they stick with Singletary. And not much of a hole there as he gets it down to about the 24-yard line. Tackle made there by Frank Clark.
Yeah, things were pretty stacked up there in the middle of the line. A lot of bodies, not much space. I think ultimately, he was fortunate to get anything out of that run.
The run only got a yard. Here's second and 9. Allen. Looking for Beasley. Got him on his slant. And he takes it down to the 10-yard line.
Never make the mistake that the slot receivers, especially the little guys like we're watching here, are just quicker than fast. A lot of them combine quickness and speed, and they catch a lot of footballs, as we just saw there.
So not quite a first and goal. It's first and 10 from the 10. They run here with Singletary. And they'll be driven back here, losing yardage to the 10-yard line. That's going to go as a loss of one on first down.
An interesting and intriguing decision there defensively, because they kept extra DBs on the field despite seeing the multiple tight end look that came out for the offense.
I thought they were going to switch out of it. I didn't know if they felt they didn't have time or what the case was.
Well, in any event, the extra speed allowed for great penetration as they stuffed that one behind the line of scrimmage.
Moved back to the 10. They'll try on second and goal here. Again, it'll be Singletary. And he will maneuver his way down to about the 7. Two runs in a row, but only 2 yards to show for it.
Partner, I know we're in a goal-to-go situation, but my goodness, think about running the ball here. Not even a thought, is it?
Yeah, defensively, they're in a prime spot.
And I think the defensive guys are probably expressing themselves to them as well. I wouldn't run it here, guys. You might want to try throwing it.
He will find Diggs in the end zone. Touchdown, Buffalo. A 7-yard touchdown grab. And the Bills are an extra point away from tying the football game. And all about timing there on that short slant, Charles.
Exactly right. That was timed up so well. The route, the throw, touchdown.
The call is to go for one and kick the extra point. It's up and good. So these teams match touchdowns here in the first quarter, and we're tied 7-7. So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. From a yard or two deep, here comes a return. And that decision to bring it out ends up not being a good one. Costs him about 5 yards as he's tackled at the 20. Kansas City taking the field for their second drive. And they had to wait a long time to get the football back. Probably not what you were hoping for when you got an offensive tumble.
Agreed. What you were looking for is the defense get the ball back pretty quickly, right? Hoping for a 3-and-out. So that didn't happen. You can't yell at your D for that. They've got to take care of their own business and reestablish themselves now that they're back on the field.
Mahomes will lead the Chiefs up 1st and 10 at the 20. Now back to throw. Man open is Robinson. Sheds off the tackle. Touchdown! DeMarcus Robinson. An 80-yard touchdown. And the Chiefs have taken the lead. Seeing some pretty good offense here in this first quarter.
It's been a wild start to this quarter, as you noted. And now with that lead that we're seeing, can they retaliate? I get the sense this one's going to go back and forth all game long.
And that probably won't be the last long touchdown that we see in this one. Butker on for the PAT. It's up and good, and it's 14-7 now here in the first quarter. Those are the ones the offensive coordinators dream about. One play drives from that distance. What an effort. It results in the touchdown. Now after the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away. from his end zone, Isaiah McKenzie. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23. Back now on offense, the Buffalo Bills. And for them, a touchdown their last go-around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
Allen and the Bills now with a first and 10 at their own 23. Throwing to start the drive. Allen, it's Knox, the tight end, making the catch. And the result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves him with 2 to go on second down.
How about the timing on that one? Boy, they were in sync, weren't they? 3-step drop, balls out of his hands, right to the tight end. Nice completion, just like they do it in practice.
Only needing 2 yards on second down. Allen going to give this one to Singletary. And he'll be brought down shy of the 40 at the 38-yard line.
Well, they came into this game saying it was important that they set the tone and show that they can run the football. I believe that they've done that here in the first quarter.
So here's a first and 10 at the 38. They'll run here with Singletary. Singletary, a first down and more. And he's going to get this into enemy territory at the 45. Consecutive plays now where that offensive line has really created a lot of space.
And we've seen the confidence rise, haven't we? It borders on arrogance now, and that's that good arrogance, believing you can run the football whenever you get good and ready.
So now first and 10 in Chiefs territory at the 45-yard line. They'll run on first down with Singletary. Shrugs the tackle.
Nice.
Still going. They can't stop him. And he's taken down inside the 30. 51 yards rushing for him as he's got the afternoon off to a great start.
They're making it look easy out there. Another first down. So far on this drive, let me do this little bit of math here. 4 plays. 3 first downs?
That's a pretty good recipe for success. First down, and they're going to throw with Allen. Oh, it's a screen pass. That's complete. A good rally to the football keeps him to only a yard, and it's second down.
As a defense, you're more balanced when you're in zone coverage because you're able to keep your eyes on the quarterback and see the play develop in front of you. They're able to keep the quick pass in front of them and stop it right at the line of scrimmage.
To throw again on second down. Allen, and this throw incomplete. The defender all over him that time, and it's going to lead to third down.
I think that's how this defense is going to need to play these tight ends. Again, get right up on them and stay physical. And that paid off on that play, helping force that incompletion.
After an incomplete pass on second down, that'll leave him trying to convert on 3rd and 9. Allen now looks to throw. And he comes back with 1 complete. And he is going to have a Bills first down as they're able to get the 3rd down conversion.
One of my old teammates called me the other day when he was watching the game. He's like, man, trying to watch an NFL game and trying to account for their passing game, that's difficult. And just when you think you get everything covered, here comes a back out of the backfield. And in this case, he picks up a first down.
So the ball down to the 16 here for first and 10. It was Jaron Reed who got him down.
That's a strong pickup right there on first down. And as this drive goes on, we're seeing an offensive line and running game imposing its will.
Second down and 5. Now Allen. This throw incomplete, nearly picked off. And with his pedigree, he doesn't drop many of those. But third down coming up.
I know in every game we do, we talk about momentum. That was a momentum play lost. And now there could be a letdown because they didn't get the interception.
Yeah, you could almost hear the collective gasp on the sideline as he could not come up with that football. Allen from the gun on third down. Well, I'm not sure he saw the linebacker there as that's batted down and incomplete.
I think that was a good job there defensively. They did allow him to drive all the way downfield, but once they got their backs to the goal line, they really turned up the pressure.
Yeah, they let him get all the way down here. Now the field shrinks. They've struggled to convert, and that last incompletion brings up fourth. The kick by Bass is good. And they'll cut the lead back down to 4 now at 14-10. So a good kick there, and they put the bow tie on it with 3 points.
And let's face it, everybody wants a touchdown. We know that. But in the NFL, defenses are awfully good. You're not going to score each and every time. Be able to knock the ball through the post and take the three.
By the way, I said bow tie. I meant just bow.
Either way.
Not the tie, but yeah.
Either way.
You got it.
I just went right past it.
So after knocking through the field goal, here's Bass to kick it away. From a couple yards deep, he'll bring it out of the end zone. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24. KC's offense ready to take over. And last time, the formula was pretty simple. One play drive, long pass. That maybe they just want to do that again, right?
And that's exactly how you want to draw things up, whether it's on your grease board, right, in your playbook. One play drive is exactly what you want on offense. What they have to be careful of is not having a letdown. It was fairly easy last time. They can't expect that going forward.
Yeah, we'll see if it's that easy here. Mahomes will lead the Chiefs up first and 10 at their own 24. And from the shotgun, he'll throw. Now into a sea of defenders and intercepted. Picked off by Micah Hyde. And he'll get this back to the 32-yard line. Well, he's certainly not been afraid to take some chances downfield. Now look, it's paid off for him a couple of times. That time, not so fortunate.
And that's where I want to start, what you said. It's paid off a couple of times. So his aggressiveness, it's been good for his offense for the most part. So he throws an interception there. No one likes that, but I would not rein him back in. The return on investment thus far has been pretty good. 2 touchdowns to 1 interception.
From the 32 now, here's first and 10. So after the INT, it's Allen finding Knox there, complete. Now after the completion, we're going to get a timeout, an injured player. We'll step aside and get an update when we return to Arrowhead. Second down, Singletary. And he'll take this close to a first down at the Chiefs 23. It's a 5-yard gain, but they'll still be a yard short here with third down now looming.
I think we can safely say that those types of plays are the backbone of this offense. We know not every run's going to be a big hitter, but you know they'll take that type of result on each and every attempt.
They'll try and run for this with Singletary. And he's going to have a first down here as he gets this one to the 17-yard line. 62 yards rushing for him now on what was his 10th carry of the ball game.
Well, someone's been having a good game so far, and you know something? A lot of it's been power running. They decided to turn him loose again on third down, didn't they?
They did indeed. He delivered the tough yards. So from the 17 now, here's a first and 10. So the shotgun snap to Allen. He's got the connection over the middle to Diggs. Down he goes at the 10 with a solid pickup of 8.
I always laugh when people say, what's the toughest route to defend? And I'm like, any of them, especially if it's a good receiver. That makes things very difficult. But when you're running a drag route, something short, shallow, going through defenders, using guys almost as screens in order to get open, that makes things tougher, guys trying to get to the football.
Rolling to his right. And Allen will have the first down as he's able to slide to avoid the contact at the end.
Now, how about that play? He took a possible negative and turned it into positive yardage and slid down to avoid taking a big shot. Excellent job getting down and avoiding the big hit.
Here's Allen. Looking end zone, but it's incomplete.
Well, the gap man coverage on the outside, and my scouting report on these DBs tells me that they love to take matters in their own hands. They want man coverage, not zone. And there was good coverage there that forced the incompletion.
They come up here with another shot from the 6-yard line, and it's second and goal now. On the handoff, it's Singletary. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Buffalo touchdown. Devin Singletary, a 6-yard touchdown run. And the Bills have retaken the lead. That almost looked too easy, and I think thanks goes to the offensive line for making it look easy.
Yeah, I agree with you totally on that one. I'm not sure how much everyone understands the preparations that go into a game for an offensive line. Because there's a reason that running backs and quarterbacks give them big gifts at the end of a season after a big year. The consistency and the continuity it takes to know each other and execute their blocks is pretty impressive.
Extra point by Bass, up and good. And it's now 17-14. After the touchdown, Bass to kick it away. Taken in at the 3. And they'll start this drive just across the 30. Pretty nice work on the return. KC offense out of the huddle, ready for their next drive. And last time, one play interception, so this offense, they should be fresh.
That's a good way of putting it. And I can't wait to see what they decide to do with play calling, because a one-play drive where you throw an interception, a lot of people think the very next time out, run the football, don't give them a chance.
Maybe play action.
I think maybe you go play action, show your quarterback, get a little confidence in him, and let him fling another one.
An entertaining start to this one. More to come on EA Sports. Second down, a run with Edwards-Helaire. And he'll get up near the 45. They'll spot it at the 44.
I know what you're thinking out there. I know a lot of people thinking, take a shot downfield. second half. Right now, I think they were just trying to get some momentum built. Get a first down, pick it up, and keep moving.
Now Edwards-Helaire, and he'll work this forward for about three. It's second down.
Not the kind of game that we'll go absolutely crazy for, but it's the kind of game that you need to have when you're running back in the NFL. And Clyde Edwards-Helaire, with that low center of gravity and strength, he's going to get those tough, gritty yards for you when necessary.
Yards on that last carry. Here's second and seven. Now here's Mahomes. And that falls to the ground, incomplete. A nice job of bodying him up defensively. And now it brings up third down.
My first thought is surprise, because that's one of the better tight ends around, and I've seen him pull in balls like this before. But how about a little credit to the defense forcing that incompletion?
Throwing is Mahomes on third. He'll find his running back, Edwards-Helaire. And he will have a Chiefs first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
I'm not sure that that was necessarily a safety valve or a check down throw on third down. Sometimes just try and find the open guy and get him the ball. He did exactly that and found a way to pick up a first down.
So first and 10 now in Buffalo territory at the 41. They go play action. Now Mahomes. And going deep for Hill. And that is caught on the right sideline, but out of bounds, says the line judge. The throw took him a little too far. It's second down.
Thus far, they have been able to move the line of scrimmage very well in the running game. Almost felt like they said in the huddle, can you guys pass protect? Let's take a big shot downfield. Didn't get it on that one, but they may come back to it again.
Again, they'll throw with Mahomes. The tight end, Kelce, has it over the middle. And he's got a first down as the tackle made at the Bills' 31-yard line.
Good strong throw right there. And so far in this game, the alleys have been open for them to get completions, and they're taking advantage of it.
Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. From the gun, it's Mahomes. And he'll get this into the hands of Hill, complete. And he's taken down, but not before reaching the 10-yard line. And with that completion, he's now north of 200 yards here in the first half. Boy, a tough start for the secondary defensively.
It is, and it's got to put a dent in their confidence. And, you know, you always want to keep that up and feel like you can always bounce back after plays. But with the kind of numbers he's putting up here, it's starting to wear on them a little bit, I think. So they're looking at each other and trying to figure out what defense will work and how can they play better without getting beat deep for big passes.
Now it's Mahomes again. Got his man complete over the middle. That's Robinson. 3 yards the gain there, second down.
Fired that one in there, able to make connection on a nice in route.
With those faster passes when they're going that fast, any hesitation as a quarterback that the deflection, if you miss, might be bigger and lead to an interception?
Yeah, and the deflection works both ways. Maybe a defender gets a hand in the way and it pops in the air, and sometimes you throw it so hard your receiver can't handle it, and he pops it up in the air for the defenders to grab as well.
But a moot point there as they were able to connect.
And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. No gain on the play, and it's going to bring up a third down.
Early down stuff's to put this offense in a precarious position. We know that securing the point of attack, especially against the big-bodied guys in the middle of this D, has got to be priority one.
Working from the gun, Mahomes. Yeah, this pass broken up. Excellent coverage there on third down, as that was not an easy one to hold on to.
And I think they'd be well served to take that type of a physical approach against him the rest of the game. He's had his way so far, but on that last one, that worked quite well for the defense.
So on fourth down, Mahomes off, Harrison Butker on for the Chiefs field goal. This just a 24-yard attempt. Butker's kick here is good. And that will tie things at 17-all. Drive took him inside the 10. Good job defensively to hold him to 3.
Yeah, I like how you did that. Give a little tip of the cap to the stop troops there, because they didn't give up a touchdown in that situation, right? Made him kick the field goal, and yeah, points went against them, but it feels a whole lot better running off the field.
The score, all even to this point as the kick's away. Returning it, Isaiah McKenzie. And a decent return out to the 27-yard line. The Bills' offense now, they get set to head back onto the field. And we have seen a lot on the scoreboard here in this quarter. So you talk to me about tendency breakers on offense. These defenses struggling. Are there tendency breakers on defense?
All defensive coordinators keep something in their hip pocket for these types of situations. What can we do to slow down the onslaught? But the biggest thing is make sure these guys encourage each other, pick themselves up, because right now it's been a really tough ball game trying to stop these offenses.
Oh, it really has, especially as of late. On first down, they'll start out with Singletary. 74 yards rushing for him as he has been tough to stop here this first half.
Well, I think after that run, the defense is getting back in the huddle and looking at each other and maybe starting to question their confidence a bit. They gave up a significant run, 6 yards, and now you're saying to yourself, how do we stop them, and do I have enough confidence to make a play?
On second down at 4, Allen. He hits Beasley right side. And he gets this up across the 35 before he's out of bounds.
Timing is everything, and they work on this cut all the time. They work on all the timing patterns, and this time it paid off for him. Worked him to the center of the field, cut it to the outside. Ball's delivered. Gets both feet down for the completion.
On third down, they go with Singletary. Singletary loses it. And he's going to have a Bills first down as he's able to get this up past the 40.
Wow, that ball gets knocked free, but a teammate comes along and scoops it up. It's almost like baseball. Guys at bat, people are on base in scoring position. One guy doesn't get them home. The next guy comes through and picks him up.
And avoids the turnover. They'll run on first down with Moss. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
Came out in a power set, but that only served to put more men in the box. And guess what? If you're going to do that, you've got to win up front, right? Your offensive guys have got to beat the defenders. They lost all leverage on that play.
So the first down run lost a couple. Now they come up second and 12. On the give, this is Singletary. And he'll be brought down just shy of the 45.
On a second and long, it's really nice to see an offense that has enough confidence to run the football in that situation. I think that goes back to their practice and game planning. They've seen things that they've seen on tape and in previous games that led them to believe that even in a long distance situation, they can still run the football and gain enough yardage to put themselves in a good spot on third down.
And that is knocked away in the middle of the field and incomplete.
Receiver coaches preach to their guys all the time, separation, that's what's going to make the play successful. That time there was very little, and I think they were actually fortunate that it was only knocked away and not intercepted.
On fourth down, Matt Hawk to punt it away. It's a 40-yard punt, 4 yards on the return, and it's Chiefs football, first and 10. And now here comes Kansas City. And last time they got 3 points, but it was a chip shot field goal. And when you go to the sideline after a chip shot field goal, maybe the offense not too happy.
It's a balancing act, isn't it? Because you're exactly right. They're none too pleased that they didn't punch it in for 6 points. But they also have to remember they did put points on the board.
3 points is 3 points.
And in this league, you take points when you can get them. Not easily done.
Mahomes will lead the Chiefs up first and 10 at their own 17-yard line. The drive will begin with a run by Edwards-Helaire. Shoves him aside. And way up past the 35 before he's taken down.
I think you and I were both raised the same way in the game of football. You run to set up the pass, but I think we've discovered in this NFL, a lot of teams pass to set up the run. And that's what they've done throughout this game. They've aired it out, thrown it around the yard. Now they've come back to the running game, and they find a way to be successful with it.
One play has him to the 37 here for first and 10. They'll run here with Edwards-Helaire. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play there. Second down.
We talk about defenders, specifically linebackers, keeping their eyes in the right spot. He had that eye down the entire time.
And you know that's not easily done because they throw a lot of misdirection at you. They try and fool you and get your eyes in the wrong place. But you're right about that one. He correctly figured that one out and made a really nice play.
And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. So in the second quarter, he's already up over 100 yards receiving now.
And isn't 100 the magic number for a really good game for a receiver? So he got a chance to really shatter that and have a profound effect on this game.
First and 10, it's Edwards-Helaire with it. And he sneaks his way forward only for a couple here. Second down.
Well, any lane that might have been open there was closed pretty quickly, and that was because the defensive front, they won that battle at the point of attack at the line of scrimmage. They used great leverage, held their spot, and stacked him up.
The last run good for two. Here's second and 8. Here's Mahomes to throw. Throwing the out route incomplete. That's Robinson. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. And now with that completion, he's north of 200 yards here in the first half.
And he's going to break our statistician, Marvin, isn't he? Because Marvin right now is just tallying it up. Hope his hand doesn't hurt too much doing this or keeps hitting the calculator. But my goodness, what a start he is off to. By the end of this game, he could have monster numbers. He just wants to continue to be accurate.
And he'll work this forward for about 3 at second down.
Yeah, I don't know if it's exactly a win-win, but if you're on offense, you'll take that kind of a run, all right? It was kind of stacked up, found a little bit of yardage, and frankly, they're pretty close to staying on schedule on offense. The playbook is still open for the coordinator.
From the 36, Mahomes, and a flag comes in as that one falls incomplete. Let's see who this is on. So flag for the contact, pass interference.
And I know that you're going to look at me and roll your eyes, and rightfully so, because you know what I'm going to say. Doesn't a defender have a right to the football as well?
No, I don't like defenders.
That's because you spent too much time with me. Okay, I'll side with you on this one. This is the correct call.
On first down, Mahomes. And that is incomplete. Oh, the coverage a little too good there, and it's second down.
They went with a dime look on defense. Two extra defensive backs on the field and covered up essentially every blade of grass. That allowed them to disrupt the play.
After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. Mahomes going to throw. His throw incomplete.
Not only did he have a chance to scan the field there, it felt like he had a chance to scan it twice. The protection was that good. Unfortunately for him, the coverage downfield, equally good.
This offense was on the move. Now two straight incompletions have them looking at third and 10. Looking to throw is Mahomes. It's complete to Robinson. And he will have a Chiefs first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
Oh, that was a pretty route right there, because it's all about finding a window on a route like that. He lined up on his left, ran the deep in route over the middle, and the ball was right where it needed to be. Really good trust between quarterback and receiver. Really good completion.
Now a first and 10 at the 11. Second quarter, 2 minutes to go. Tie ball game. Mahomes to throw once more. This one hauled in, and again it's Robinson. And this will leave him a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down.
And we've seen him have success earlier on with the ball in his hands, because he is a get it in space and make a play kind of a receiver. But that time, they closed on him quickly and held him to a short game.
Second and one from the two. They'll run with a backup. This is Williams. And he'll go backwards, losing yardage to the five. They go backwards there 2 yards, and second and one is now third and three.
The short field shrinks even more with the type of bodies they brought in on that play. Those extra tight ends, they weren't able to secure their blocks, and that one ended up going backwards.
An extra defensive back here for the Bills on third down. Shotgun snap to Mahomes. And oh, it'll be intercepted. Snags it for the pick. And the Bills are going to have it here as they'll start at their own 7. Charles, not only is that an interception, it's one when you were really knocking on the door for a touchdown inside the red zone.
You're actually thinking points. No matter what, at worst, you're thinking kicking a field goal and getting 3. We might look back on this in the second half and say, you remember when they didn't get points on that drive? This could cost them.
The Bills offense back out onto the field. Tie ball game, still a little more than a minute to go in the half. The question, can they put something together here, try to take that lead into intermission?
I would have to think that would be the goal for sure. I don't think you sit on anything here. Here's your opportunity. Push it downfield. As you mentioned, it's a tie game. So minus a disaster on your part, you've got that in your back pocket. Go ahead and try and get some points and feel great going into the half.
Allen's throw going to be caught by McKenzie. And a productive gain out to the 14 after starting at the 7. It's a gain of 7. This time they'll just keep this on the ground. And they'll get him down here at the 23. 87 yards on the ground for him now, as he's done that on 15 carries. So nothing separating these two teams as we head to the break, all square. As we send you down to Orlando, where Jonathan Coachman has our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach.
All right, Brandon, thanks very much. Welcome, everybody, to our abbreviated version of the EA Sports Halftime Report. We thought this one would be a close battle coming in, and we have not been disappointed. But they are all even to this point. So to see if either side can pull away, let's get you right back out to Brandon and Brian Charles for the start of the second half.
Coach, thanks. Yeah, both teams likely to make some changes in what's been a closely fought battle to this point. Started for the second half. It was an even first half, all tied on the scoreboard. This fielded right at the goal line. And he'll be tackled just shy of the 25. The Bills offense set to take over to begin quarter number three. It's a tie football game here. What do you think, Charles, the message was at halftime?
Well, I think that they probably just looked at things and said, we're fortunate that this is a tie game. No need to panic. No need to change a whole lot. We didn't play anything close to our best in the first half, so we don't have to go out and win one for the Gipper. Let's just go out and play our best football and win one for us.
We couldn't ask for much more to this point in the second half. A gorgeous day, one-score game, first and 10 here. On play action, Allen. And this one caught by Beasley. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Now, those linemen, of course, can't be more than a yard downfield when a pass is thrown, and they might have been able to call that on a couple of guys there. Here's Singletary. Limited running room as he'll get about 3 to the 21.
Well, obviously they would have at least liked to have gotten back to the original line of scrimmage. Instead, now they're dealing with second and long.
I thought they would have passed it after the penalty. Probably wish they would have now.
Second and 12, Allen, and this throw incomplete. Well, the defender all over him that time, and it's going to lead to third down. So, Charles, tie game here. What are your keys as we continue to play this second half?
I know people think it's always trite when you say the same things over and over, but they're tried and true in the game of football. Who's going to block better? Who's going to tackle better? In this case, to me, it's turnovers. You've got to take care of the football in order to win the game.
This is brought in by the tight end, Tommy Sweeney. And this will not get close to the first down marker as he's brought down at the 26. Just a 5-yard pickup, and it leads to fourth down.
Brandon, a good idea there on third down. Run a little clear out and hope you can get your receiver the ball coming across the formation. Nice design, but well played defensively, and they stop him well short.
Here's Matt Hawk now, as he's on to punt for Buffalo. It'll be a 39-yard punt, no return, and possession will switch hands, first and 10. So here's the Chiefs offense ready for their first reps in half number two. And the interception thrown in the red zone last time, we'll see if they can rebound.
I just have to think the last thing he said as they went back out there was, don't do that again. What do you think?
What do you think?
Yeah, I think that. I think that not only did he say that, but he also told him, let's put it in the end zone that it's supposed to be in, all right? The end zone we're trying to score. I know we're being a little bit facetious here, but the bottom line is take care of the football, and everything else should flow from there.
Quick lesson, never ask the play-by-play guy a question.
Hey, you're my partner. I know you're right there with me.
And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8, 2nd and 2.
Completion was given up, but that's why you play zone defense, so that you can have people around the ball when it's caught, and you don't give up much run after the catch.
Second and two. They go play fake. Mahomes. Another pass into the reliable hands of Kelce.
That was a round run, not just with dexterity, but with intelligence. Found the hole in the zone, made sure the quarterback saw him, and was able to make the sure catch and flip the down marker back to 1.
A shotgun snap and a give to Edwards-Helaire. And he'll only get a yard, maybe 2, up to the 46.
Oh, that's a real nice job there by the defensive front. They just engaged and held their ground. But how about the guy who made the play? We often talk about whether they take a good first step or not. Many times you just don't take any step. Just get your feet moving, get your body going. And then once he made the read, he was able to make the play.
Throwing on 2nd and 8. Mahomes quickly into the hands of Robinson. And he's got a first down as the tackle made at the Bills 42.
He's certainly been a huge factor in this one. He's got the 2 touchdowns to his credit. Now they look to him again. He picks up the first.
Yeah, I can hear everyone saying, well, why don't you cover him? Double him, triple him, do what you have to do. But sometimes they get locked into such a groove and such a connection, it doesn't matter how many guys are in his area.
He certainly looks to be in that groove right now.
So 1st and 10 now in Buffalo territory at the 42-yard line. Mahomes now to throw. He'll let this go for the end zone. And this one almost intercepted. Had a chance to come down with it in the end zone, but could not hang on.
I remember a coach telling me a long time ago the difference between playing corner and safety in the NFL. Corner is like the Autobahn. Everybody just flying by, and these corners have been really busy in this game, although they got it done on the last play.
On the last play, yes, but there have been some good numbers put up against them offensively.
And Mahomes misfires again, and it's intercepted. Picked up by Tremaine Edmonds, the linebacker. And the Bills are going to take over at their own 30-yard line.
Second straight drive now here, Charles, that have ended with an interception.
And I just wonder, because I don't think it's going to rattle him necessarily, but I also wonder if it's going to unnerve him a little bit. Does it lead to another one? Or does he find a way to pull it together and become sharp again?
Buffalo offense back out, ready to go.
And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
Allen and the Bills now with a 1st and 10 right at the 30. A play fake to Singletary, and now it's Allen. They'll roll him out right. Nice work to get 7 out of that, and it's 2nd down.
Now, that was not a bad scramble there on 1st down. He didn't force it, nor did he throw it away. He was able to take off, and now he made it a very manageable 2nd and short.
Three yards remain for 2nd down. On the ground, it's Singletary. Singletary, a 1st down and more. And he takes it across the 50 to the 46-yard line.
It's been an excellent day for him running the football, no doubt, as he continues to soar well past 100 yards.
Yeah, it almost feels like he can just grab his briefcase and head home after putting in a full day's work at the office, doesn't it?
On first down, they stick with Singletary. And he can only manage to get a couple. Second and eight coming up.
Certainly a nice job there by the defense rallying to the football and getting him on the ground. But I think the play gets made by the defensive front, because if they can't get upfield, their job is to go ahead and get low, almost get into a ball sometimes, stack things up, and make it difficult for the runner to find a hole.
And now they'll throw with Allen. On the left side, he finds Beasley. From the 34 now, here's first and 10. To throw, it's Allen. And a quick throw here, that's complete. And he's going to get this down near the 20-yard line.
Ah, that's tough to play zone defense when they can just curl up right there in front of you.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, we talk about finding the soft spot defensively. How do you make sure they don't find the soft spot like they did there?
Tough to do, because what they normally will do is run routes that'll pull you out of that spot they want to get into. That's what we call not taking the cheese, right? Don't go for the mousetrap. But it's hard to do, because when you see a guy cutting that in that direction, you tend to go towards him.
It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it second and 4.
Frustrating for a defense, energizing for an offense. Finding a way to create that type of yardage in your running game, that'll make the guys carrying the ball very, very happy.
From the 16, Allen over the middle, and it's incomplete.
It certainly didn't appear that that's where he wanted to go with the ball initially, so he tried to get something out of it by dumping it off to his running back unsuccessfully.
Here's the seventh play of this drive. This is 3rd and 4. Throwing now is Allen. Now he's got it. And he'll be taken down at the 2-yard line.
Well, that certainly has to feel good. It's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit. Sometimes I think in the huddle, the quarterback just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here. And the end result there, nice first down. Drive keeps moving.
Let's go, Nady!
Moss. And he is into the end zone for a Buffalo touchdown. Zach Moss taking it in from 2 yards out. And the Bills have broken the tie. And nothing special there. They show they were going to run the football. They ran it. They got it in.
Like old-time football, right? Hey, this is exactly what we're going to do. Straight-ahead power, and they got it done.
Here's Bass now for the extra point. And they will take a 7-point lead now. So that drive consumes 9 plays all told. And it's culminated by a 2-yard touchdown run. After the touchdown, Bass to kick it away. And it'll come out to the 25 as he will not attempt to return. And the Chiefs now getting set to go. And 3 interceptions in this game. And I would have to think, I wasn't a quarterback, but number 4 is kind of, oh, you're like, oh, man, I can't throw 4.
No, and what's interesting is, what do the coaches decide to do now? Having thrown 3, do you alter your offensive strategy? Do you take the ball out of his hands and maybe turn to the running game? Or do you have that supreme confidence that he's going to turn things around?
We'll see what they do. Mahomes will lead the Chiefs up 1st and 10. at their own 25-yard line. They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. And they work this well upfield across the 45.
Certainly no settling into the drive there. They came right out on the first play and attacked the middle of the field for a big gainer and a first down.
A big hitter to start the drive has him up near midfield here for first and 10. Now Mahomes. They complete it to Hill. 5 yards on the catch there. Brings up second down.
It's a game of matchups, and that's why you take your receivers and move them around a bunch, especially your best guys. And when they work out of the slot, you often hear the coaches talk about how great it is because it gives you a two-way go. You can break out or you can break in. That makes it hard to defend.
From midfield, here's Mahomes. And that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on, third down.
He was trying to get that one out to his running back out of the backfield, but that one was read and timed perfectly, and they were able to break it up.
They come up now, third and 5, following the incomplete pass. And again, it's Mahomes. He is going to find Hill here. And he will have a Chiefs first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. And with that last play, he's now up over that 300-yard mark.
And in today's NFL, it almost feels routine. And I hate that when you talk about a 300-yard passing game. To me, 300 yards still signifies excellence, and he's achieved that in this performance.
From the 34 now, here's first and 10. Edwards-Helaire as they run out of the gun. Jerry Hughes on the stop.
And that's exactly what you want on a first down run. Pick up 5 yards, bring up second and 5. The defensive line, though, they've got to figure out a way to out-leverage the guys up front because the offensive line is winning at the point of attack.
After the pickup of 5, here's second and 5. To throw, it's Mahomes. Gets this one to Hill.
This has to go down as one of the simpler routes in the playbook, but oh so effective. Nice completion there. Keeps the sticks moving.
Throwing on first down is Mahomes. Robinson's got it. And he'll go out of bounds in the red zone just inside the 20. That will go as a pickup of 7 on the 7th play of the drive. Boy, the evolution of the game and how these guys in plays like that can get out of the pocket, keep plays alive, it just makes things so much harder for defenses.
It really does, and we're talking about an era in the game where the quarterbacks are the most athletically gifted that we've seen in a bunch. I mean, when you talk about collectively, it's unbelievable. So their ability to move is practiced now. It's not necessarily, oh, he just took off and you guys figure it out. When he takes off, everyone knows where to go now. They know how to run routes, change things, make themselves presentable for the quarterback. It's a lot of time that they put in on it. It's not just your static 1-2-3, this is where the ball goes anymore.
Right back to Edwards-Helaire on first down. And he's going to work this one down to about the 5. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a 2nd and 3.
Well, no matter how they phrase it, staying on schedule, staying ahead of the sticks, whatever you want to call it, 7 yards on first down, that fits the bill.
A good run, got 7 on first. Here's 2nd and 3. On play action, it's Mahomes. Flushed out right. And he stopped after a gain of 1. Not enough. Still a yard to go on third down. extra time to come up with his third down play as we played three quarters. We'll return with more. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. The Chiefs on third down. They've converted three out of five thus far. Here it's third and two. Throwing now is Mahomes. And in for the Chiefs touchdown. Mahomes finding Tyreek Hill. And the Chiefs are an extra point away from tying this game here in the fourth. We are set up for a fantastic finish now. A fourth quarter touchdown here. We're an extra point away from a tie football game.
And I know they're thinking about possibly going for two, but I'd go ahead and kick this one and just get it back to level.
Butker now to add the extra point. And an important one that is, as we are tied now early in this fourth quarter. So that one, a long 11-play drive. And it winds up with the Chiefs hitting pay dirt. Nothing separating these two sides. 24 all our score as he sends this one away. Taken at the goal line. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24. The Buffalo offense and Devin Singletary heading back out there.
He's been a good workhorse. I know we use the word workhorse a lot, but he's been a good workhorse for him in this one.
No doubt about it, and there's nothing wrong with that. That's what you're looking for if you're a back, because that means everything's coming together for you. Big guys up front have created space. You've run through it, and you've probably got some help even from the wide receivers who want to catch passes as opposed to block, but they're helping out too.
Yeah, everyone's pitching in. He's had a good game. Play action, Allen. And that'll be knocked away. It's incomplete.
As a defensive back, you have some weapons at your disposal that we don't often talk about. And you can read the receiver's eyes, you can read his hands, and you know that the arrival of the ball is imminent, and that allows you to make a play on it and oftentimes knock it away.
Complete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. Allen now looks to throw. Allen hit. He lost the football. And it's picked up by the Chiefs. And his guys will take over at the 30-yard line.
Well, so much for the four-minute offense. They were trying to reduce the clock, get in position to win the game, and leave no time for them to come back and catch them. And guess what? They turned the ball over.
Yeah,
I mean, they had it all set up for themselves, and they let it get away.
Now the Chiefs offense, they get ready to head on the field. The fumble recovery certainly has put them in the driver's seat. First and 10, all tied here in the fourth. After the fumble recovery, it's Mahomes taking a deep shot here for Hardman. And he's got Hardman in the end zone. Touchdown, Kansas City. Mecole Hardman, 30 yards. And the Chiefs use the short field to their advantage as they cash in for six.
Did you see them hold up four fingers at the start of the fourth quarter?
They were ready.
They were definitely ready. They may or may not have done that, but they certainly have played that way. The fourth quarter has belonged to them, and now the lead belongs to them as well.
Butker on for the PAT. And they will take a 7-point lead now. They got the ball in great field position. One play later, boom, end zone. After the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away. Isaiah McKenzie now on the return. And able to take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. Buffalo set to get the football back here. And now, after the touchdown a moment ago, they work from behind in a 7-point game in this fourth quarter. Plenty of time on the clock. Now with a first and 10 at their own 28-yard line. He'll give it to Singletary to start the drive. And he's going to take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. Second down.
Well, from an offensive perspective, that was a tough run because he only picked up 3 yards. Well, let's flip it over to the defensive side. They now have the advantage. 3 3-yard gains, that means they're punting the ball likely on fourth down. That's what you're looking for when you're playing defense.
From the 31, Allen. Sanders has it over the middle. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down.
I like the design that we're seeing right there. This is what they need. Down by a touchdown here in the fourth. They just need to keep working their way downfield. And when they see openings, take their shots.
Throwing on first down is Allen. And he finds Beasley complete. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. Tell you what, he's been able to put the ball in some tight spots all game long. That throw, no different.
Yeah, a lot of people would call it a gutsy type of a throw. I think he looks at it as, I can do it, so it's not that big of a deal to me, and I'm going to keep firing.
The drive continues as they search for a tying touchdown. Here's first and 10. To the air, Allen going deep for Diggs, and it is incomplete. Good positioning there downfield to break that one up.
This defense is continuing to contest every deep ball that is thrown downfield, and look, it doesn't matter whether you're playing man or zone, eventually that becomes man on man, and you got to trust yourself and go up at that moment of truth and make a play on the football.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. Now Allen. And on the catch right side, this is Sanders. And he'll be brought down with a first down as the tackle's made at the Chiefs 23.
Well, the obviously red man covers their partner, and he got downfield, broke down the defender, made him
think.
What
do you mean by that?
He made him think he was going to run a different route. Probably thought he was going to take it upfield, and then he curls back inside for the completion.
Get 19! And they'll throw with Allen. And his throw here is incomplete.
Certainly appeared to take away his first read, and by the time he tried to look elsewhere and find an open target, the coverage was too good. That one falls incomplete.
Once again, they'll go from the 23-yard line on second and 10. Working out of the shotgun, here's Allen. That is caught at the 7. And all the way down inside the 5 to the 4.
But one of the ways the quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field. And here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup.
A looming decision to make on the conversion, down 7, but first things first, they need to score as they come up on first and goal. Now Allen again. Oh no, he lost the football. And the offense is able to pounce on it inside the 5-yard line. Fortunate to get that football back, because trailing here in the second half, last thing they needed was to lose the possession.
And the word I think of here is opportunity, because it could have been lost there, their chance to score points. But the opportunity for the defense was to go ahead and really close this game down if they were able to get possession.
Very fortunate to get another shot. Here's second and goal. Gonna throw under pressure, and they got to him again. Jaron Reed muscles his way in for the sack.
So once again they dial up the pressure and get home and get a sack. It brings up a third and long, but it's really not an unmakeable one, especially considering they just gave up back-to-back sacks.
Two straight sacks have them backed up now for a third and goal. Here's Allen to throw it. Sanders got it for a Bills touchdown. A great play there. There to make the grab. And the Bills are an extra point away from tying the football game. Tyler Bass now for the point after. And no sweat, he puts it through, and we are tied here in the fourth. A 10-play drive that time, and it culminates in a Bills touchdown. Set to go now with the kickoff. These two teams all even again as we continue in this wild fourth quarter. And this will be a touchback, so they'll bring it out to the 25. And Kansas City's offense now set, ready to go. Well, they just gave up the score to tie it. That's the bad news. The good news, plenty of time in this fourth quarter to try to grab that lead back. Will lead the Chiefs up first and 10 at their 25-yard line. Here's Edwards-Helaire as they will start on the ground. And not a whole lot of room to operate there on the first down run. He gets maybe 3.
Not a lot of running room there. Not a place to make a cut and kind of exit out, because they had everything bottled up. Looked to me like the linemen were taking on their blocks really well and giving up no creases.
The last run got three. Now here's second and seven. Now here's Mahomes. To the right side, it's Kelce. A pickup of about 3 yards as he's taken down at the 31.
I'm wondering if the same thing went through your mind as mine. When I see a big man like that make a catch, all I keep thinking to myself is, big man with football. Look out, everyone. He may not juke you a whole lot, right? He may not run past you because of his size. You talk about a guy weighing in the 270 range. But boy, once he gets his mitts on the ball, he's going to be tough to bring down.
And he will have a Chiefs first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
Part of the tie game in the fourth quarter, you and I both know in the NFL, that's when you lean on your stars, and he came through with a nice catch right there.
Play action. Now it's Mahomes. And going deep for Hill. And that went a little too high as it's knocked away and incomplete.
Finally, a good play there defensively on the deep ball. The secondary has had its struggles this entire game. Offensively, they've had their way with them.
Here's second and 10. Again, they'll throw with Mahomes. They're going deep for Hill. And that's going to be incomplete. Good effort there, trying to take a shot, but it's third down.
After what they faced during this game, where they've given up a ton of yards downfield, that has to be a measure of revenge right there for the secondary. They've been shredded throughout the game and finally forced an incompletion.
The Chiefs on third down. They've been very good, 5 for 7 thus far. This is third and 10. Working from the gun, Mahomes. And they take him down. The Bills get to him. That was Jordan Poyer, the safety in for the sack.
How about that? One of the so-called little guys putting the pressure on. That was a strong safety. When I was in college, we often called that a lightning blitz.
Here's the Chiefs punter now, as he's on a punt for the first time this afternoon. Fair catch called. It's taken in right at the 20-yard line. So a change of possession here on the punt. And the Bills will take over the football with a first and 10. Here's the Buffalo offense now as they get set to take over here. Excellent job by their defense to force the punt and provide them with this opportunity, all tied in the fourth quarter. Allen and the Bills now with a first and 10 at their own 20-yard line. Off play action. Allen out to his left. And he slides and covers up at the end as he's going to be able to pick up decent yardage. The improv on the scramble there gets him 6, and it'll be second down.
Partner, he was going through his progressions. Not there, not there. After about the third one, he decided he better pull it down and run for it. And he slides down and avoids the hit for good measure.
On second down, here's a run with Singletary. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40.
Oh, that's one to warm the hearts of all those old school football players, isn't it? Tough, hard, gritty run. Got behind his pads, bowled over a few people. Look at that one, right up the gut.
Saw it through three quarters. No reason to lighten up now. Here's Allen on first and 10. It's Knox, the tight end, making the catch. And he'll be stopped right at midfield.
And what a nice example there of a tight end doing exactly what he needs to do. How about how he worked his way to the outside, made sure he secured the catch, and then anything after that, we count that as a bonus. And indeed, he gets enough for the first down.
They'll run on first down with Singletary. And good penetration here. He'll get this down only to about the 49-yard line. Chris Jones on the stop.
Now, that's a mountain of a man that just made that stop, isn't it? But he's more than that. This guy's nimble and quick. More than a space eater, he just made a great play there.
Here's second and nine, just a yard on that last run. Here's Hallett. Steps away. He'll wind up getting four there on his own, but it will leave him now with a third down situation. So the shotgun snap to Allen. It's complete to Diggs. And he'll be brought down with a first down as the tackle's made at the Chiefs 26.
And this was a nice example of an offensive coordinator scheming his guy open, just a little underneath route, just trying to free up some space, and it worked awfully well. Got him not just space, but plenty of room to run after the catch to pick up really nice yardage.
They'll run on first down. Singletary. And down inside the 15 he goes.
Another carry for their leader and a good one. It's crunch time. They'll need him to continue to be productive in both the run and passing game in order for them to try and snatch a victory.
Stuff all tied with 2 minutes remaining on EA Sports. So it's Bills football here as we get you reset. They've got it first and 10 as they search for a go-ahead score. They'll run here with Singletary. And now they're inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9. Give him 5 on the carry there, and it'll be second down.
But they picked up a little bit of yardage there, and now, in this situation, should be in no hurry to run a play really fast. Let the clock wind down.
From the 9, second and 5. Allen going to give this one to Singletary, and he'll be stopped just outside the 5 at the 6. Still a couple yards short of the first as the 3-yard gain brings up a third down. Now, what's the thinking here? Because a touchdown would be nice, but you've insured yourself a chance at 3 in the lead, so how worried are you about the 6?
You're not very worried about if you're confident in your kicker. And if you got a kicker who can put it through the post, you feel really good about trying to bleed that clock down.
And he'll take it into the end zone for a Buffalo touchdown. Devin Singletary, his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Bills have broken the tie. Well, they were looking to pick up the first down on third and short. They got a little more than they bargained for, finding the end zone as well.
And oftentimes in short yardage situations, you get a lot of defenders stacked near the line of scrimmage, partner. So if you can get past that first wave, there's usually room to roam, and he found it.
Bass on for the extra point. And they will take a 7-point lead now. So that one a pretty time-consuming 10-play drive. And it was finished off by a Devin Singletary touchdown run. after the touchdown. Bass to kick it away. This taken in at the goal line. And they'll get him down right at the 25-yard line. So the same result, but he opted for the touchback. Patrick Mahomes in the offense. Down by 7. 1:04 on the clock. How will this thing pan out? We'll watch as they come up on first down. To throw it. Pass complete to Edwards-Helaire. And they work this well upfield across the 45.
Got his 3 timeouts left, right?
Think you got to use one here, don't you?
No doubt about it. I'd use one right here.
First down now, but that clock rolling. Mahomes will throw. Now a swing pass. It's Edwards-Helaire. The Chiefs now going to use the first of their timeouts as the clock will stop with just under 30 seconds left to go. The drive continues as they search for a tying touchdown. Here's first and 10. Mahomes. He finds Robinson. Now another timeout called for by the offense as they'll stop the clock with 24 seconds to go in the game. Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. Mahomes. And he can't get a throw off. He's taken down. What a huge play at this point in the game. Well, they're in some hot water now after that sack. It's 2nd and 21. Mahomes. There goes a deep ball. End zone. And that'll be incomplete with 11 seconds remaining now. The way he's throwing the football today, almost a surprise when he doesn't complete a pass like happened there, but he needs a few more to get his guys downfield.
Well, the way he's thrown it leads him to believe that he's going to get those completions. And that means the guys going out for passes, they'll run even harder because they expect it as well.
Here's Mahomes. And his pass is intercepted for the 4th time today. Teron Johnson able to pick it. And the Bills have just about sewn up this football game.
Another costly turnover, their 2nd of this second half. And earlier when I asked you your keys to the second half, you said, hey, it may be trite, but I think it's turnovers. That's coming to fruition.
It certainly is. And let's face it, they named the game after it, right? So isn't it the most important thing?
But the football.
Exactly. They named the game for it. Take care of it.
Down to a knee, and that should just about do it. So it's a victory here for the Buffalo Bills, and they were buoyed, Charles, by a big second half to put this one on ice.
And I know a lot of people watching this one were thinking to themselves, I'll bet halftime was really interesting. Probably took the paint off the walls with some of the words that were said. But I get the sense that it was much more of the adjustments they made. They came in with a game plan that we saw that didn't work in the first half. They made the adjustments necessary, went away from that, and then they got it together, got a spark, and then took off. It's really nice to watch in the second half.
So that'll do it for us. For Charles Davis and all our crew, I'm Brandon Gauden. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. From Kansas City, so long, everybody.